My name's Sarah Roach.
My name is Lizzie Mintz.
I'm Kieran.
I spent this last year serving as the Hatchet's copy editor.
I'm the former editor-in-chief of the Hatchet.
And I was formerly the Hatchet's managing director.
When I first joined the Hatchet, I just wanted, it was more of a personal endeavor. Like, I really just wanted to improve my, like, video skills, my writing skills, things like that. And as I continued on with the Hatchet, I kind of realized that it had a greater impact than I anticipated.
The Hatchet is a place where I was able to both find a community on campus and also a place where I was able to feel like I was doing something meaningful.
When I first got to college, I knew what the Hatchet was because I had a high school counselor who said, whatever school you're going to, make sure you read the student newspaper because they'll really give you the pulse on what's happening on campus.
I think the Hatchet did a very good job of making me feel connected to campus and to the community on campus, even when I wasn't a part of it.
When the COVID-19 pandemic originally broke out and sent students home, it was very difficult because there were so many things that we didn't know how to do or just that we'd never tried out before.
It was really hard to maintain my connections with sources and continue to, you know, establish those relationships that I had built before COVID.
It was really difficult to build camaraderie with staff when everybody was working at different parts of the world.
It's hard when there's no students on campus and we're a paper that talks a lot about student life and what's happening on campus.
My assistant copy editor and I were 3,000 miles away from each other. And, you know, in previous years, everyone would be in the townhouse all day.
I kind of realized over the past year how important that townhouse was. You know, you think you can operate a paper from different parts of the world, and you can, but you definitely lose that sense of morale that you can really build just in being around people you work with. And I would say it's really important to have that space. And one of the costs that we've been really challenged to pay, and one of the reasons GW made an exception for it, was that townhouse.
You know, I think the power of student journalism is that, you know, we are working without pay, you know, 20 to 60 hours a week, depending on the job. And
our editorial board, my year as opinions editor, was a really, really good tool for pushing back against what administrators were saying and asking for transparency from student government, from administrators at the university, from the faculty senate.
From what I've seen over the past 4 years, some of our best reporting has been this past year, and I think it was just because our staff knew that we couldn't let anything fall through the cracks despite being online.
I'm proud of the fact that the Hatchet prints a paper once a week, and that's something that we definitely need to be able to keep doing, so that's what I'll be watching for.
Being on the Hatchet is the best thing that I could have done over the past 4 years.
I loved its influence on the GW community, and I really, really wanted to be part of a group of people that wanted to make it better because they realized that impact as well.